Electric Mustang crossover. The words, they don't really make sense when you say them out loud, but that's exactly where we're at, and that's exactly what I'm standing next to right now. This is the Mustang Mach-E, and it's here to make you rethink what the word Mustang means. So the Mach-E comes in both standard and extended range trims with both rear and all-wheel drive layouts available. 300 miles of EV range is best case scenario, but even the base car will do 210 miles. In terms of performance, we switch our attention to this guy. This is the GT Performance model, and it packs 459 horsepower and 612 pound-feet of torque. That'll help it hit 60 miles per hour in just about 3.5 seconds. So Ford obviously needs to be in the EV crossover game, and rather than do something a bit more mundane like an Escape or Explorer EV, the company's trying to inject some life into the car by calling it a Mustang. Will that move pay off? We're not so sure yet. But you can't deny that it at least makes it a more visually exciting vehicle. But let's look at it a bit more closely. We see Mustang very obviously in the face with the car's logo dead center, though the one on the Mach-E is actually slightly different than the one on the regular Mustang. The headlights are sharp and angular and definitely derivative of a Mustang. Look around. You won't see a Ford badge on this car anywhere. Mustang logos only. The side profile is where things get a bit weird. It maintains its sleek lines, but toward the rear three quarters where you lose me. We're deep into personal opinions at this point, but I just don't think it looks as good as some of the other crossovers it competes against, like the Jaguar I-Pace, for example. But at least there's a party trick. You notice anything that's missing here? There's no door handles. So instead what you do is you walk up, press this button that's just above the door, and you're good to go. Inside the Mach-E, let's get straight to the elephant in the room. It's a 15.5-inch touchscreen display, and it only has one physical control, and that's the volume knob. Everything else is done via the touchscreen. Then in front of the driver, we have a 10.2-inch digital instrument cluster. A lot of screen inside the Mach-E. And when you look at the materials used with the interior, there's no animal products. You're not gonna find leather or anything like that. Instead, what you end up with are these sort of alternative materials is the best way to describe it. It's really futuristic looking and certainly not characteristic of anything else in Ford's lineup. If you were jumping at the chance to drive the Mustang Mach-E, Ford will take a $500 reservation and that'll hold your place in line. You can use that deposit for any of the trim levels, the GT Performance model included.